What's up guys, Sal here. So one thing that was really surprising to many is that the iPhone 14 Pro lineup has a display that's better in one of the key aspects than the S22 Ultra. To be specific, the outdoor peak brightness is 2000 nits higher than any phone on the market, even better than the S22 Ultra, which has 1750 nits of peak brightness. So you might be wondering, isn't Samsung the one providing displays to Apple in the first place? So how come they're providing better displays to their arch rival instead of using it on their own devices first? Well, the answer is pretty straightforward.
This is business!
This is my sweat!
I know, but I did business!
Shut up!
This is business!
See, Samsung is the biggest display supplier for iPhones. But they aren't the only display supplier though. LG and BOE also provide OLEDs to Apple. And there was a talk recently that Apple wants to lessen their reliance on Samsung because they don't want Samsung to know about their plans for future iPhones well in advance, as Samsung is a direct competitor to Apple. And considering that Samsung makes billions of dollars every single year just by supplying components to Apple, it's important that they keep Apple happy for Tim Cook to keep coming back to Samsung. And that's the reason Samsung provided a better display to the iPhone 14 Pro compared to their own S22 Ultra. Moving on, you might have seen Samsung mocking the iPhone 14 already, but it looks like Samsung isn't alone in trolling Apple. They've got company, and it's none other than Steve Jobs' daughter herself. She shared the viral meme of a man buying a shirt identical to what he's wearing in the photo, highlighting that the iPhone 14 is essentially the same as the iPhone 13. Basically, she was not impressed by the new iPhone 14. Anyway, here's one of the reasons why I'm not really a fan of Apple. You see, after the iPhone 14 event, Tim Cook was asked about RCS support on iMessage. If you don't know, RCS is a next-gen SMS protocol that upgrades text messaging. It enables many of the benefits Apple users already get from iMessage. Basically, it will end the blue bubble, green bubble debate altogether if Apple decides to implement it in iMessage. So a journalist told Tim Cook that it was difficult for him to send videos to his mom who uses an Android because Apple devices don't support RCS. To which Tim replied, and I quote, "I don't hear our users asking that we put a lot of energy into that. Buy your mom an iPhone." It's the first time Apple is publicly addressing RCS, and the response was quite arrogant, I would say. To be honest, this isn't even a thing in the rest of the world. We have WhatsApp, Signal, Telegram, and more to send texts, images, videos, and more. But it's a big deal in the US for some reason. Apple clearly knows that iMessage amounts to serious lock-in, as said by the Apple executive himself. If Apple wants, they can fix it in a day, but they won't because it removes that barrier for people to go get an Android. It's an anti-consumer behavior that hurts even their own users, but they don't care because all that matters to them is making more money. Anyway, click here to see Samsung mock the iPhone 14 Pro, and I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.